Hi there, welcome to this video about Discus Agile conference. Myself, Jaya Srivastav. I'm an Scrum coach and trainer based out of Bangalore. And presently I'm representing Discus Agile conference member. And we are having Saket with us, Saket Bansal from Delhi, who is one of our track chairs for this conference. And Saket, would you like to introduce yourself?
Sure. So I'm Saket and I am into the business of education. I help people to learn new emerging trend, primarily focused towards managing product and projects. And I spend good time teaching agile related topics. I train people on Scrum, Kanban, and various other agile stuff. And I would be taking care of one of the track, which is all about pragmatic agile, or I would say hybrid agile, where we try to make use of agile in imperfect word. So we don't have a perfect word to apply agile values and principle many times as it is. So it's more about how do we become agile in imperfect word.
So Saket, I know our conferences is like in very limelight in Bangalore, and people is already started asking about this conference, and it's gaining all the recognition, most like too much of recognition. So it was a nice idea. Why don't you tell us a little more about this conference so that people who are still like out of Bangalore and out of India would know much more about our conference?
Thank you, Jaya, for asking this particular question. So along with the track chair, I'm also a conference chair. This is like a conference which I have been running for more than 3 years, and we do in multiple cities in India. But this time what I thought is that why don't we have a conference which is a collection of conferences? Because many times we go to a conference and we find that this is not the type of thing I was looking for. There is no theme in the content. There is no ownership of a part of the content which is getting presented by the speakers. And it's usually difficult for one chair or one organizing group to go through all the contents and become an expert in all those areas to take care of quality. So this time it's a conference of conferences. It's a conferences of mini conferences, which we are saying track. And we are identifying track owners to ensure a good quality speakers, good quality content in those respective areas. So we have a tracks on personal agility, we have a track on Kanban, and we have a track on coaching and leadership, and we have a track on hybrid agile or pragmatic agile, which I am taking care of. So this concept is first time I think we are experimenting, and I have not seen very clearly coming out by any other organizer as well. So let's see how the experiment goes. I'm quite optimistic about this particular experiment.
Okay, that's a really nice idea, because when we go to the organization and when we talk in real terms, life thing, we really accept, unknowingly or knowingly, that there is a hybrid inside the organization. When we are transforming, when we are implementing agile, or you know, wherever the some process or framework comes. So could you just let us know a little bit more, like, okay, when audience are coming to our conference, and especially when they are targeting our theme, what kind of thing they are going to have there? And what is the idea behind choosing this title? Because it's like, you know, if I'm saying the example of Scrum is a framework, and it like framework never fails. But when I'm saying hybrid agile, I'm having like little, What's there in your mind, like which you
true,
want
true,
in there?
That's an interesting question. So if I look at the intent, and before the audience, I need to attract speakers. So the type of speakers I am looking for is that they bring their agile story, which they are implementing and generating value in their context, which is not a pure agile mindset context. Now, I'm using very ambiguous word, abstract word, pure mindset, agile. Everybody can have their own meaning for it. But if I be more specific, people working in a team where the team is constituting people, individuals from different organizations. So unlike a one organization team, you have individuals coming from different organizations, and you are representing one delivery team. And these different organizations have conflicting goals, but still, because of a type of contract they are in, they want to work as a one team. Now, how do you bring agility into it? What kind of experiment you might have done which helps you to bring that agility? Another example could be that you have a vendor and customer relationship, and we do believe that there should be trust, there should be collaboration, but the way the contract has been designed, the people who evaluate the money flow, they don't believe in trust and collaboration. They need some hard data. And as an Indian service provider, you are in a very complicated contract where you will only get the money when your terms get met. Now, when you have a stringent contract which requires to be adhered to in order to get the money for the organization, how do you bring agility in that context? How do you adapt? So it's more about, I would say, rather than pragmatic agile, where you say that I adapt my agile practices so that I get agility in a complicated, traditional mindset-driven environment, and how much success I have achieved in that context. That kind of a stories I'm looking from the speakers. And if we get those kind of stories, that kind of experience I am trying to offer to our audience, that this is how these guys have done it, rather than you keep abusing this organization is bad, they don't understand agile, they must change this, they must change that. But these guys have found a solution in that kind of rigid world. Still, they make through. They bring some value by keeping those big boundaries and big rigidity in place.
Got it. So to summarize, I'm seeing like you are looking for real time experience in their talk. You are looking for how they have mapped their process, what all tools and techniques they brought in order to bring true agility in their work. That kind of talk you are expecting, right? For our speakers to submit in this conference. Saket, so when they will go out, like our audience will go out, could you just list out like few very nice takeaways from your theme?
Yeah. So from my theme, what I'm looking for is that when my participants, the individuals who attend the talks in these areas, when they go out with a mindset that they can bring agility in any context. They can be adaptive in their practices the way the situation needs it, and they will deliver value in all the possible complex, rigid scenarios. So rather than just thinking that it can't be done and this has to be done, management has to change, leadership has to change, organization has to change, they can say, okay, you may change gradually, but I will show how I can bring value incrementally in the context. So focusing on, I can do it, rather than, this is not working. So they get inspired to bring agility in their complex environment.
Great. Looking good. I'm feeling excited to hear those people. So Saket, is there any submission deadlines or like how we are going in that direction?
So that's relatively little bit abstract as of now. And what we are expecting, that's a very great point. This time we are going to do an incremental acceptance of talk. So we may start accepting your talk the within 2-3 days you accept it. You submit it. The idea is you submit a talk through our discussagile.com website. We may provide some reviews, and in all probability, the talks which are good or which are meeting some threshold, we will invite you for a video call like this, and we will hear your story, and this story will be available to the audience. So audience starts talking about it, asking questions about that particular thing, and based on those interactions, your talk will get submitted, your talk will get finalized. So it's not traditional way of waterfallish way of running the conference where we have a line milestone for accepting the talks, and then review starts, and then the agenda comes in. It's agile way of running the conference. You think of a topic, you put it across. We start looking at it. We have a conversation with you. Rather than just talk, we will have a conversation with you, which is anyway available to the audience. Once the audience find value in it, we have some way to measure that. Your talk is final. You come.
Great, great. So this is something new which we are doing in our conference, that you are like good to go, and you are, and not only that, once you will hear the questions from the audience, from your video, it gives you opportunity to inspect and adapt there, right? So whenever the rest of the audience will be coming like in live to your session, they will have nice takeaways. So this is very nice idea, Saket. I really appreciate this part that you have come up with this, what you call true empirical way of submission, I would say. So it's really good. Saket, could you also share some URL link or where they can get to know more about, and some like social media thing
So as of now,
for benefit.
true. So as of now, the discusagile.com is the URL, and once you go there, you can see a banner about the Bangalore. And we do have a Twitter handler, which is again Discus Agile. So Twitter at the rate Discus Agile. Just these two avenues are good enough to get started, and gradually we will communicate more and more things. We do have a Scrum Alliance user group called Discus Agile, so you can join in there as well. And best place is go to the website and find the details.
Great. So, Saket, thank you very much for your time. And I hope we are going to have all the track chairs, similar kind of video for their theme line. So, thank you so much for your time. Thank you.
It's my pleasure. Thank you.